We are going to start with topic number 9, control and coordination. Before starting with the topic, you should know the meaning of these two words, what is control and what is coordination. This control is concerned with nervous system and coordination is concerned with endocrine system. This two system works in coordination with each other. What does it mean? See, in case of multicellular organisms which are made up of many cells, where cellular tissue, organ and organ system organization is there. In these cases, as you know that here the organ and organ systems are there, these organs require their own controls, and when the systems, when many systems come together, when they work together, coordination between the system is required. So control is because of nervous system, and this nervous system is for this control of these systems. That means we can say the single organs can be controlled by their own, and organ systems, they work in coordination with each other, and for this coordination here this endocrine system is there, which works through different chemicals which are called as hormones. So remember that these two systems, control and coordination, works in harmony with each other. This nervous system, it is due to electrical signals, and endocrine system is due to production of chemicals which are also called as hormones. So these systems working in coordination with each other. We have to study this control. We are going to start with control first, and this control is found in case of plants as well as in case of animals. So we consider here control in case of plants first. In case of plants, it is because of the various type of we can say the stimulation. We can consider here phototrophic movement. This phototrophic movements, as the name suggests, it is because of light. That means light sensitive. Here we, you know that roots are not attracted towards the light. These are geotropic. And if you consider the shoot, shoot is phototrophic, which is attracted towards the light, movement towards the light. In case of plants, chemotactic movements are also seen. These chemotactic movements are, it is attraction towards the chemicals. So when movement is there, plant organ or the plant part movement is there due to the chemicals, it is called as chemotactic also. Okay, so in case of plants, such type of movements are seen in response to photo, that is light, in response to chemicals. But in case of animals, last year you have seen that the animals which are multicellular are classified into invertebrates and vertebrates. These vertebrates are the animals without vertebral column, and second category is there, which are called as vertebrates, animals having vertebral column. If you are going to consider about their complexity, invertebrates are simple as compared to vertebrates. In case of invertebrates, we have seen different phyla, starting from phylum Porifera. This phylum Porifera consists of animals generally called as spongies, where cells are grouped together with intercellular spaces in between, and hence this spongies just simply having aggregation of cells. In such cases, there is no organ system formation, there is no tissue also, so there is no coordination between the cells. All cells work by their own, or we can say their own governed, they are self-sufficient. simply just simple aggregation of cell is gate form, so there is no nervous system. In case of invertebrates, after phylum Porifera, another phylum is there which is called as Nidaria. I think you remember the example of phylum Nidaria, and this example of phylum Nidaria is Hydra. From this Hydra onward, this nervous system start evolving, start developing. So what type of nervous system is seen in case of Hydra, and what is its complexity, we are going to see now. So we are going to study about nervous system in Hydra. This nervous system in Hydra, it includes nerve nets. What is this nerve net? Nerve net is for the network of nerve cells, which are also called as neurons. So neurons come together and form a net-like structure. How it is, we'll see. We'll see that body of Hydra, as diagrammatically you know that, I'm going to draw here a simple diagram. It consists of tentacle. These tentacles are present, and from this here a body of Hydra is present. This is the body of Hydra. These are the tentacles, and this mouth is present. This is the mouth. In case of phylum Nidaria, this is the gastrovascular cavity. This gastrovascular cavity means the cavity concerned with the digestion. Word gastro is for stomach, and vascular for the vascular system, generally which is the blood vascular system, which is not modified in case of Hydra. Okay, so this gastro for stomach and vascular system, function is performed by this system and hence called as gastrovascular system. We are there with the nervous system in Hydra. Now just consider that this is the body wall in case of Hydra. This is the body wall. And on this body wall, you can see nerve net. Nerve net means just simply a net-like structure is gate form, where the nerve cells are joined together with each other. In this case, here this type of nerve cells are seen. And this is the network-like structure is gate form. So this network-like structure simply is seen in case of Hydra. Then this network-like structure of the nerve net, it is divided into two parts. That means we can consider one of the nerve net, which is outer nerve net, which is outer one, is present towards its gate combined with, or we can say it have its connection with the epidermis. And one more is there, which is called as outer nerve net, second nerve net. This second nerve net, which is the inner one, it is in connection with gastrovascular cavity. As this gastrovascular cavity was shown, so inner nerve net is in connection with the gastrovascular cavity, and the outer one is in connection with the epidermis. That means if we consider this is the gastrovascular cavity, this inner one is the gastrovascular cavity, there will be a nerve net towards the inside in connection with epidermis, in connection with gastrovascular cavity, and this is the outer surface. One more nerve net will be there, which is in connection with the epidermis. So these two nerve nets are found, and between these two nerve net, here a layer is present, which is called as mesoglia. If you remember, last year we have studied about the diploblastic and triploblastic type of animals. These Nidarians are diploblastic, having outer wall of ectoderm. Inner layer is called as endoderm, and in between these two layers, your mesoglia is present. And in this mesoglia, towards the outer side, a nerve net present connected to epidermis. And inner side of mesoglia shows inner layer of nerve net, which is get connected to the gastrovascular cavity. One more thing you have to remember, that in case of nervous system in Hydra, two types of cells are seen. First type of cells are called as sensory cells. The sensory cells are for catching the impulses from the outer side, and these neurons are the nerve cells, which are the structural and functional unit of nervous system. So this type of nervous system is seen in case of Hydra, which is of primitive type, which is of, we can say, less evolved system. Now one more animal and its nervous system we have to see, and this animal is planaria. Second example, nervous system in case of planaria. Nervous system in case of planaria, remember that it is the most primitive animal. It is a most primitive animal in which nervous system shows most primitive animal in which nervous system shows central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. CNS for central nervous system and PNS for peripheral nervous system. Okay. So remember, planaria, the most primitive animal, which belongs to phylum Platyhelminthes from invertebrates. So this Platyhelminthes from invertebrates, that means in the invertebrate phyla, first phylum is Porifera, second Cnidaria, and then this is the Platyhelminthes. Just after the Cnidarian, this phylum Platyhelminthes or flatworms are present. So what kind of nervous system is seen in case of planaria? It consists of CNS and PNS, that is, which is seen in case of evolved animals, in case of vertebrates also. So this CNS and PNS, what it shows, remember that this CNS is because of presence of cerebral ganglia. This cerebral ganglia means the brain. Okay, so this, it is also called as brain. And the second part of CNS is called as ventral nerve cord. This ventral nerve cord, its short form is VNC. So VNC, ventral nerve cord, and brain are the parts of peripheral nervous system. And this peripheral nervous system, its second part, it consists of transverse nerves. These transverse nerves are the nerves which joins the ventral nerve cord. Okay, so diagrammatically we will see it in short. What type of system is seen in case of this planaria? So this planaria, this animal, it consists of this type of triangular head-like structure, and it shows this type of tubular body. So this upper triangular region is for the head, which consists of eyes in this region. So here this brain is found in the head region, which is called as cerebral. Cerebral is always related with the head. This cerebral ganglia, it is a inverted U-like structure like this. This type of inverted U-like structure is there. And your eyes are also surrounded by this nervous tissue. So we can consider this is the cerebral ganglia. This one is cerebral ganglia. This is brain. From brain here towards both the sides, this nerves comes out. Number is 9 toward both the sides. So this, with the help of this nerve, this upper part will be regulated, will be controlled. And this brain towards the lower part, it gives rise to this ventral nerve cord. Remember why it's called as ventral? Because present towards the ventral side. This is the characteristic feature of invertebrates. This nerve cord is present towards the ventral side. Now this ventral nerve cord here, they are joined together. This is the part which are called as transverse nerves. Function of transverse nerve is to join these two ventral nerve cord. Then what does come under PNS? This PNS, it shows the nerves towards the lateral side. These are the nerves which come towards the lateral side of the body. This will forms peripheral nervous system. Okay, So this is a simple type of nervous system which is found in case of planaria. But remember, most primitive animal belonging to phylum Platyhelminthes is showing central nervous system and peripheral nervous system both. Okay, so what we have seen, there is a particular evolution in the nervous system, in the organ system is there. So phylum Porifera, there is no tissue organ system, nervous system is also not present. But from Hydra onward, from phylum Mediaria onward, the system is somewhat get developed and showing the evolution. Okay, so in case of nervous system, in case of planaria, we have seen CNS and PNS, and here the scattered cells are present. Which cells are present in the scattered way? These are the sensory cells. Sensory cells for receiving the stimuli. Okay, so this is about the nervous system in case of primitive animals. Thank you.